Good morning, students. Next important topic is physical map of India. It is of 10 marks in your question paper. Along with the physical map of India, political map of India is also important, just to know the states, because sometimes a state is also asked in the question. So go through the political map of India. Now rivers. First topic is rivers. Now rivers are very important. All the black color lines which have been shown here are rivers. You can see Satluj and Betwa had given already, and blue color, these are the arrows which is indicating towards the river. Now there are total 24 rivers which you have to mark in map. Any one will be asked in exam. Like here you have Kaveri in the south, then Tungbhadra, Krishna, Godavari, Tapti, Narmada, Yamuna, Chenab, Jhelum, Indus, Bees, Ganga, Gomti, Ghagar, Gandak, Kosi, Brahmaputra, Damodar, Mahanadi, Chambal, Son, Ravi. So these are the different 24 rivers which has been shown. Any one will be asked. So what you have to do, only you have to put arrow towards that black color line and write the name of the river. Clear? Next is ranges. From the north, if you can see, here it is a Karakoram range that is parallel to Indus River. Next is Aravali range. Now this Aravali range is in Rajasthan. Next is Vindhyas range. You see Vindhyas range. It is just above Narmada River. Satpura range. It is in between Narmada and Tapti River. Western Ghat. Western Ghat running below, from below the Tapti River to the southern part. When you draw, it will only touch the origin of the river, not over the river. It is a continuous ghat. Now next one is Eastern Ghat. Now the Eastern Ghat is a discontinued ghat. It is little bit away from the coastal area. Here these are the ranges. Next, peaks. Important two peaks are there which you, in your course, which you have to mark. First one here, K2, Mount Godwin Austen. This is the highest peak of India, and Mount Kanchenjunga. So these are the two important peaks. You can see here, it is on the border of Sikkim and Nepal, and here it is in the northern part. Okay, it is on the ranges of Karakoram range. Next one is water bodies. Now this area showing the Gulf of Mannar. Then this indicating, arrow indicating inside is Gulf of Khambat. Now next one is, here you can see inside this area is Gulf of Kutch. Then pointing inside Sri Lanka and India is Pearl Strait. Then here arrowing towards the coast of Odisha is Chilka Lake. Then here this is the area of Andaman Sea. So these are the different water bodies. What you have to do, you have to arrow towards that water body and then you have to mark the place. Passes. Passes means gap between the mountain to cross or go to another country or place. Now, first one here is Karakoram Pass. You can see it is a Karakoram Pass. Clear? You have to mark two dashes for the Karakoram. Next one is Nathula Pass. Here it is on the eastern side of Sikkim. Okay, Nathula Pass connects to China. Clear? Now next is, here you have to mark Thar Desert. Thar Desert, western edge of India is the Thar Desert. Then in between Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat is Deccan Plateau, or it is also known as Peninsular Plateau. Next, that is a mountain, Himalayan mountain, shaded in yellow color. Then Malwa Plateau, you can see here, Malwa Plateau is on the western side of Chambal River. And then you have Chota Nagpur Plateau on the western side of Damodar River. Now minerals, important minerals of India. First, you can see here Mumbai High offshore. That's how you can mark that. Also I shown you that is a black color point showing Mumbai, and then that area is Mumbai High. Next is Jharia Coalfield. It is just in front of Damodar River. You have to put a point, that will be a Jharia Coalfield. Now Singhbhum Iron Ore, the blue color point is Singhbhum Iron Ore. It is in Odisha. Now Digboi onshore oil field. Onshore means it is inside on the land area, so it is onshore. And Mumbai High is offshore. So it is just near to Brahmaputra River. Okay. And just be careful in marking because it's an area of Assam. So it should be inside Assam, not outside Assam. Just see the political map and this map together. Thank you. I think it's clear to you. And now, one added video is here. Just go through how I had marked the places in the map. Just follow it and then mark and learn the places in map. Thank you. Good morning, students. Just now I had explained to you about physical map of India. Now I'm just drawing it to show you how you have to draw each and everything in a proper way, in a correct way, because minute things has been considered while marking it. If you not mark in a proper way, then you will not get correct number. Okay. Now I'll start from the southern India. Important things. I'm going to show you how to mark Western Ghat. We just use this point, and this point. And then join this point here, it will be drawn like this. So this is Western Ghat. You will write here. Western Ghats. Okay? This way. Next is Eastern Ghats. You see, it is a little curved line, then leaving it, and then you draw line here. Why this? Because it is a discontinued ghat. So this is, you can see I'm putting arrow towards the place, eastern ghats. Clear? Now in between the Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat is Deccan Plateau. Yeah, I'm just shading this portion so that it's clear to you. You can use different colors to shade it. So this portion is known as Deccan Plateau. Clear? This is Deccan Plateau. Now above this we have Tapti and Narmada River. In between that, you will not touch the coastal area, you will draw a line not over the river but in between the river. This line, I put an arrow towards this, is Satpura. Satpura range. Above that, we have here Narmada River. Just touching the origin of the river, and you will draw a line here. This will Vindhyas. Vindhyas range. Clear? Now, above that, here, indication of this and this. This is the area. Isn't this? If you add and make an arc, little higher, make an arc. Okay, now this is Aravali range. Okay, this is Aravali range. Now come to the northern portion. This is a Jammu and Kashmir region. Make a cut here and another one cut here. Okay, just draw a line parallel to Indus River. Now this one is Karakoram. This is Karakoram range. Karakoram range. Clear? Now, the next one is here only. I show you. This is the portion. Now you make a two cuts here. Okay. Now these two cuts indicate Karakoram Pass. These two lines indicate Karakoram Pass here, and the other pass is here. This is the area of Sikkim. Okay, now if you make a cut here, two cuts, then this is known as Nathula Pass. This Nathula Pass is connecting India and China. Okay, now come to here. This is Damodar River. And in front of Damodar River, if we draw a circle like this, not over the river, but this is not over the river, this is the other side of the river, okay? Over the river, so this area is Chota Nagpur Plateau. Chota Nagpur Plateau. It is a storehouse of minerals, okay? Now, this area is Chambal. Okay, on the side of Chambal, if you draw a circle, I'll make a shade here, draw a circle. This is Malwa Plateau. I just write it here. Malwa Plateau. Clear? So these are the different ranges. Now I'm going to show you water bodies. Here, the first water body is in between Gujarat. This area is known as Gulf of Kutch. Gulf of Kutch. Here in this you will put an arrow and write down, and this is Gulf of Khambat. Okay, here it is inside. Inside this area is Gulf of Khambat. Now in between here, put an arrow and write down Gulf of Mannar. Gulf of Mannar. Now, when you mark this, arrow should be like this. Arrow is inside. If you not put the arrow inside, you will not get marks. This is Farak Strait. This Farak Strait. Clear? It should be inside the place in between this Farak Strait. Now this area, this curved area, you can see this is a curved area, little curved area, dark area. This area is Odisha. This Chilka Lake, Andaman and Nicobar area, and this area is known as Andaman Sea. Clear? So these are the water bodies, main water bodies. Inside there are number of rivers. I just show you one. This is known as Ganga River. Okay, you will point towards the line and then you will write down the name of the river. Apart from that, desert area, Thar Desert of India. Now, this is the area of Rajasthan. Okay, so you will shade this much of area. And this area is known as Thar Desert. Clear? It's a Thar Desert region. There are few important minerals which are found in India, and for that India is very well known. Now you can see here the area of important chapter we will discuss later on. Yeah, this is the area of Mumbai. This is the area of Mumbai, and here when you cross this line, this place, this dot, black color dot, okay, this black color dot is Mumbai High. I just write on here Mumbai High is offshore drilling station. This is Brahmaputra River. Just mark a dot here, and this area is for Digboi. Digboi oil field, and it is onshore. And Digboi is in Assam. After that, here this is from Damodar River. In front of Damodar River, just put a dot, and this is Jharia. It is coal field. Here at the distance of 0.7 or 8, mark a dot again and arrow and write down this is Singhum. Singhum iron ore field, famous. Okay, so these are the few minerals which you have to mark in your topo books, tactical book. You have number of maps given at the back. You can use that map to mark, just practice it so that you can score 10 out of 10 in your exam. Thank you.